Hey, Phil from MUX here with a quick demo of how you can use SRT on MUX to deliver a great live streaming experience, even when the network you're sending a video from is less than perfect. Okay, so on the left, I've got OBS playing my favorite movie, Big Book Bunny, and I've got my live stream on the right. My live stream at the moment is going out over RTMP. It's going out at about 7 megabits a second. It's completely stable, no drop frames, anything like that. If we take a look at the live stream health, seems fine, completely stable, about 7 megabits, 30 frames a second. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to use network link conditioner to introduce some problems on this network. So I'm going to introduce 100 milliseconds of extra latency, as well as introducing 5% packet loss on both packets sent and packets received. Let's see what that does to our RTMP stream. So if we keep an eye on the bottom of OBS, we'll start to see really quickly we start dropping frames, way above like the 5% of packet loss that we introduced. Eventually we'll probably actually see that this gets a full RTMP disconnect as well, and then we'll start to see reconnects kicking in. If we take a look at the MUX dashboard, obviously we see this big dive off in the bitrate and obviously the frame rate as well. So you probably wouldn't be able to watch this. It would be a pretty stuttery mess from playback side. It's taking a lot longer than you want for frames to get into the encoder. Let's take a look at what this looks like with SRT instead. Okay, now that live stream stopped, let's reconfigure OBS to use SRT. To do this, I need the SRT URL, stream key, passphrase, but I'm also going to set up the latency of a connection. So what this does is it tells SRT how much buffer to keep on each end of a connection to compensate for packet loss, reordering, jitter, latency, all those sorts of things. So I've set that to 2 seconds in this case, which should be enough for the issues that we're introducing on the network. So let's start that stream again. Okay, so our live stream's back up. Now let's do the same again. Let's turn on our network link conditioner and see what happens to our SRT stream with 5% packet loss and that extra 100 milliseconds round trip time. If we take a look down here, it doesn't look like we're dropping any frames. We might see the bitrate start to spike a little bit, and that's because, hey, we're having to resend a bunch of extra frames, so sending some extra data. Let's see how it looks. So far, so good. Our live stream looks pretty stable. We're not dropping any frames. Our frame rate's consistent, our bit rates are consistent, so it looks like things are going well, even though we're dropping quite a lot of packets. This is what SRT is designed for. It's designed to handle these imperfect network conditions and make sure you can still live stream when this happens. Let's take a look at how our asset looks. Looks pretty good to me, even with all of that packet loss and all that extra latency. So there you go, that's how you can use SRT to improve reliability of your live streams, even when the network isn't perfect.